Barber Baskets from the Barber Baskets Show. Today is January 29th, 2014. I'm here on location at Hempstead High School where National Action Network Nan Chapter is hosting Reverend Al Sharpton's book signing, The Rejected Stone. Now, we all know Sharpton to be a very powerful force, an icon, a civil rights activist. He marched with people like Dr. King, and he himself stands up for justice for everyone. We know he got very much involved with the Trayvon Martin situation, so Barber Baskets here on location to cover this event, and I'll be bringing you more along this walk. Tune in tomorrow on the Barber Baskets Show, here live on location at Hempstead High School. With who of is hosting this event?
Ms. Baskets?
Yeah.
Annette Dennis.
Annette Davis. Pleasure to meet you.
Dennis. You're Barbara?
Yes, I am.
Yeah, you called me.
Yes, I did. Well, we're filming this event. This is Annette Davis. She is the president of the Nan Chapter.
Dennis? Thank you.
Dennis, okay. Would you please give my viewers a little information about exactly what's happening here today at Hempstead High School?
Well, we're going to have a program, a special program. We're going to have the Hempstead Chorale. We're going to have some remarks, and then we're going to have a keynote address by Reverend Al Sharpton, our president of Nan, and then he'll sign books. We're selling the books for $20, and membership in our chapter is $25.
Tonight you get a $5 break.
Oh, wow, that's a great discount.
Book and membership, $40.
Okay, let me see. Well, we would certainly like to take the time to thank you for this information. And it's very important that all residents that live in Hempstead and its surrounding areas certainly take the time to join up for Nan, because there's a lot going on in our community.
There's a lot going on in our community, for sure. We meet the second Friday of every month at 7:30 at New Life Christian Ministries, 70 North Main Street in Freeport, on the second floor. It's just right down the block, right next door to the Social Security building on North Main Street. And as, you know, people come out, we have invited guests to come out and address us, and then members of the community come and air their different concerns. So again, you know, please come out to our meetings, join. Membership is only $25. There's a lot of work to be done, a lot of issues, social justice, civil rights issues. We've got all kinds of things going on here in Nassau County and Suffolk, for that matter. We get a lot of calls from Suffolk, too.
You know, what's really sad is that we're seeing constant murders in our community. I mean, you guys are newly formed here in Incorporated Village of Hempstead. I personally am a member of National Action Network in Harlem, so Reverend Al Sharpton certainly knows my name as well as my face. I've attended that rally a lot, and I also plan on joining Nan Chapter out here. We have a lot of different organizations and groups out here, but no one is really dealing with the ongoing violence. And if anyone would like to make a donation to Nan, because I actually plan on making a $100 donation to them tonight. So please tell them where you can send a donation to.
You can send a donation to P.O. Box 1811, North Baldwin, New York. And I think, let me just find the zip code. What's that zip code?
Just getting information about
thank you,
the correct information. So anyone that would like to send a donation to Nan, the Nassau County Chapter here in Hempstead, Long Island, you will certainly have the correct information to send it to.
It's P.O. Box 1811, North Baldwin, New York, 11510. Again, P.O. Box 1811, North Baldwin, 11510. And you can also go to our website, NassauNan.org. It's NassauNan.org, and you can download an application there, and you can pay by credit card, or you can mail it into this address.
Well, once again, we certainly like to thank you for hosting this event, and it's very important that we have this huge organization. And as always, you know, Barbara Baskets has arrived in style with her beautiful limo, but guess what? There's no way for it to park, so they can deal with that dilemma later on. But like I said, I will be making a $100 donation to Nan tonight. I would encourage all my fans And viewers, please donate because we really need you guys here. And this is Barbara Baskets reporting live. Hi, Barbara Baskets reporting live. As I have said to you guys, you met the president, Terry, Denise. Barbara Baskets is going to give a $100 donation to Nan. You know, we have a lot of organizations and businesses and all these different things in this community. But I've been a part of Nan, Reverend Al Shelton, always. When I went out there to Harlem's rallies, one thing he said stuck out of my head, that when you turn the light on things, people can't hide and run. They have to face it. And we need someone to turn the light on all the violence that's going on out here in Essex County, the relentless murder. So I'm going to be the first one to give a donation. I'm hoping all my viewers will follow suit. Excuse me, I don't mean to interrupt.
That's all right.
But I'm giving a $100 donation to Nan.
Okay,
and I'm hoping all my viewers and fans will follow suit. Donate, please get involved. Not only is Barbara Baskets giving a donation, but I'm also going to pay for my membership before I leave here today. I'm also getting a copy of Reverend Al Shelton's book, Rejected Stone, and maybe you can say a few words out here to your viewers. All right? Thank you.
Congressional gold medal.
Every second Friday,
And for more information, you can go to our website, NassauNan.org. NassauNan.org. And I want to thank everybody that's working the table for me up in the vestibule, Richard Cook, Bernadette Massey, Cheryl Clark, Ronette Walker, Shirlene Aberdeen, Lorette Gregory, Darlene Allen, and Rosetta Shepherd. All right, and then we're going to turn the program back over to our Minister Soretta McKnight. Thank you all for coming. Thank you all so much. Thank you so much for being obedient. Beloved, we are feeded this afternoon. You know, this brother, you all know I talk about having roller skates on. You hear me on the radio talking about it all the time. But I absolutely hold no candle to the movement that he makes as he crisscrosses this nation, as he travels the globe. And that is to say that he is a fighter for our communities. He has stood tall. The book that he has authored, The Rejected Stone, which shares insight on who he is so that you might get a closer glimpse and look at a brother who I have had the privilege of seeing up close and working personally with for the last couple of decades before he was popular. Everybody want to get in this picture now. But there were those of us, Sister Moore, Sister Cunningham, many of us who stood on the front line with him before he got popular. Now, he is the voice of a generation. He's that prophet crying in the wilderness, and I tell you, in true Kingian fashion, we witnessed when Mrs. Coretta Scott King passed the torch to the Reverend Al Sharpton, and she did so in a magnificent way at the Grand Hyatt in New York City, and he has not dropped the ball yet. We don't expect him to, isn't that right? So we are happy, we're excited, we're delighted to welcome the host of MSNBC's Politics Nation, our fearless leader, the founder, visionary, enthusiast of the National Action Network, in the precious presence of none other than, y'all can see I'm excited, right? Anytime I'm in the presence of greatness, I get excited. I need you to rest on your feet. Rest on your feet, beloved, and let us give a nice, strong island welcome to the Right Reverend Dr. Alfred C. Sharpton. Oh, come on, come on, come on.
Thank you. Thank you very much, and certainly first to give a hand to Minister Soretta McKnight. And to all of you that have come out in this cold night, I'm very happy with, first of all of my old friends. Old being that we've been friends a long time, not that we're old. Emily Moore, Sister Cunningham, and many that have worked with me down through the years, and many of you that have seen the struggles down through the years that we have now embarked on a new level of struggle. You know, a lot of people think the struggle is over because Obama was elected, and we see with his election, it is only a matter of another level of struggle. I remember 1994, I was in South Africa when they had the election to make the ANC the government and therefore Nelson Mandela the president. That didn't end the struggle, they're still struggling. And some of us act as though you can just do one or two moves, vote once or march once, and that everything is going to be all right. It's never been that way in history. And it never is going to be that way that easily here. But if you continue to struggle, you will continue to make progress and achieve power. I wrote this book because I wanted to give a path to people to understand how you can achieve something in your life and your community. The Bible talks about the rejected stone becoming the cornerstone. And as I reviewed the Bible and reviewed leadership, it occurred to me that the people that were the most unlikely the most rejected, the ones that you would dismiss, the ones that you would say is never going to be nothing, the ones that you would say has no potential, they ended up being the ones that changed history. And a lot of us don't do things because we feel we're not qualified, or we feel that we don't have the preparation. And some of our best is the ones that are not apparent and not clear. So I write about my life, having been rejected, my father abandoned me, a lot of things that I never talked about. And I talked about the lessons I learned from people like James Brown, like Reverend Jesse Jackson, like Adam Clayton Powell, all the way to Obama. And that is what the book is about, to hopefully give people a path and an understanding, as well as to let you understand that no matter where you are in life, has nothing to do about with where you can go if you're determined to do it. You are not responsible for where you start in life. You are not responsible for your parents. You're not responsible for your economic conditions that you're born in. But you are responsible for what you do with what you inherit. That's why rich people that are born rich are ignorant to think they achieved something because they didn't choose that. And people that are born with nothing should have complexes because they didn't choose that. It's what you do with what you have. That even if you reject it, that'll make you what you can be. So I hope that many of you get the book and enjoy the book. I want to also say that I'm very proud of our sister, the president of the chapter, and Brother Pope, our vice president, that formed the chapter National Action Network out here. We're going to do a lot of work out here in Nassau County to continue to fight and continue to struggle. I remember that when I was growing up, you moved to Nassau, you thought you'd move to the suburbs. Now y'all trying to move back and to get away from the suburban hood out here. So we got a lot of work to do. Just because we are out in Long Island doesn't mean things are fair and progressive. Wherever we are, we got to work and we got to stick together. So I'm committed to supporting the chapter. I'm committed to work with the chapter. And I'm glad to be with you tonight for a few minutes and to sign a few books and to be a part of this kickoff. Thank you so much.
Barbara Baskin, getting ready to go have Reverend Al Sharpton sign my book, The Rejected Son. It's very exciting.
All right.
Reverend Al Sharpton, Barbara Baskin.
Here.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Bless you, baby.
Bless you.
Oh, we know.
You know what I'm saying? Representing us, right?
Now I can run.
About this book, The Rejected Son, and I encourage you to get it. And so that's why we're out tonight to support Reverend Al Sharpton.
Well, thank you very much, and thank you for watching. My fans and my viewers, I love giving you guys the date and time. Addison, say hi to my viewers. It's my limo guy right here, Addison. AS Limo Service.
How was it?
He always taking celebrity barber baskets everywhere, picking her up. It is January 29th, 2012. I'm sorry. January 29th, 2014. Wednesday evening, and it's precisely 8:35 p.m. I'm just leaving Hempstead High School. And listen, Barbara Baskets is really, really tired. I'm gonna get inside my little pretty limo and time to go home. So I really hope you enjoyed this show. I know I did.
Thank you.